departments, and our program was initiated with my colleague Tunde, who's a pediatrician anyway, after a preparatory phase collaboration at that time, the Zentrum für Sozialpsychiatrie in Berlin, in Germany, Professor Hartmann was the lead at that time, and this was the first program dedicated to baby mother unit, and we started as 40 years ago. So this is our team. During the years we developed a team. The current team consists of 25 members, but the team members are from the hospital, also from the National Institute of Child Health, as well Semmelweis University, and also from Germany, professor and the pediatric department, and also the general department are members. The members of the team are psychiatrists, psychologists, nurses, perinatal professionals, including neonatologists, of course, obstetric and gynecologists, social workers. So this is a kind of very complex team. So before I go to the details, you know, this is the whole conference, which is the theory behind all that is the importance of prevention. Because even in the clinical practice, we treat different problems, for example, perinatal depression, but with this treatment, we also invest in the future, and we have a kind of prevention work. So this is what is about, that when we invest across the life cycle, the best investment is as early as possible at early ages. Also, it starts not just at the first semester, but before the conception. And so this is a very important point, that even when we invest in time as early as possible, the return is the greatest, as you can see. Also, the other important point is that even you intervene in different forms, for example, pharmacological stigma against us and against our patients and those mothers who are suffering with mental problems. And during the years, it just disappeared when we evolved the pediatricians and also the gynecologists into the program, and this kind of stigma just reduced and somehow. So this is just to give a very shortly of turnover data. We since 2007 we have more than 300 mothers and 5 fathers as an index person taking part in our program, and 55 patients participated in new patients and 45 old patients. Also the number of admission to our program is growing, and as we are the only unit and center in Hungary, this is of course understandable. So the age distribution of our programs under 20 is the green. You see the pattern is, as I think I heard yesterday here from our colleagues, that the age of the first baby, the age of the mother of the first baby 25 years ago was around 20. And nowadays it's around 30 years. So this is a kind of pattern. So it reflects that we have a majority of over half between 26 to 30, so that we need to want to certify those later age too. And as with the diagnosis of the mother concerns, about one quarter of the cases were diagnosed with schizophrenia, schizophrenia spectrum disorder, also suffer major affective disorders, bipolar disorders. Around one third were in the spectrum anxiety disorders, including adjustment disorders and other form of problems, personality disorder. These are the first accident diagnosis, so this is the first, of course, comorbidities there are. morning in the window feedback, using window feedback was used observing the interaction between the mother and her child, and then we discussed it together with the client and also with the staff and the feedbacks. So, and we also emphasized the positive aspect. This is a case of a 34-year-old woman. In her history was a mentioned this, that the guidelines related to perinatal mental disorders are very important. Of course, the golden one is the NICE guideline, and also there are other ones, the Scottish one is assigned, and also last year was the British Association for Psychopharmacology consensus guidance, and also there's an information service on that. And in Canada, recently in Australia, and also Denmark, so this is growing, but in Hungary, we introduced NAID based on our program and the international experience of our Hungarian guidance. It was published officially in the Ministry of Health paper, and this is just in the case that these are psychiatrists, obstetric and gynecologists, pediatricians, and also clinical psychologists, so every, and also patients' organizations and other bodies were supported this guideline. So the further steps, financing the program is a very difficult one to adjust into the financial system, the DRG system, because this is an important one, I think here in Romania to get financed these programs. And of course, international and national grants, projects, conferences are very important as I hear, and thank you for again this. And also there are other bodies beside WPA, European Psychiatric Association, Marxist Society, and also the World Association of Infant and Dialysis is taking place an important role. So to conclude, there's a new treatment modality used in Hungary which reduces the risk of separation of baby and husband and mother recovery, as well as the utilization of family and supporting network resources. Involving fathers into the program as handling their mental health has a huge benefit and children's development, and mother's mental health and relationship between parents. Of course, further research is necessary to support this, and introducing the first the new Hungarian guidance, promising step for the future, and also sharing international and national experiences is very helpful, and we would like to continue international regional cooperation with relevant professionals and users organizations according to the international and national guidelines position papers, and thank you for your attention, and I give this file that we also like to organize a perinatal to early childhood mental health as a regional conference next day. So thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Professor Kurimay, for the very interesting presentation. And if there is any question,
or even your attention, or aggression, something like this.